Hello, this is another exciting gameplay by denc75 on Weibo. This time, white won big by killing the top two dragons, but the beginning was actually quite promising for black, so white managed to turn the tables around in the second part of the game. Let's see what happened. Very tactical journey this time. So we have two star points against two star points, then the early sun invasion, which is super trendy. And here, black kind of overplays with the Hane. Usually, play a push and Hane on the second line to secure the corner. This is the most basic variation. And of course, it's also possible to play the attach at f2. And then when white nobi, push once again. And then go e3. And now simply invade the left side to try to limit white's potential. But of course, there are more complicated strategies with g2. And then push here, go up, push and cut and so on. So this will lead to the so-called flying knife joseki, and it's also ladder related. So I mean, if white tries to kill the corner like this, black will cut, go out, then either catch the two stones at g3 or set up a ladder on the other stones. So when white resists here, atari, then this is a disaster. White collapsed, so white will connect. Black goes down to secure the corner. Now white can push several times in sente and go for the moyo, either with a jump or atari here, push, extend and so on. Well, this is a monster joseki and there are lots of complicated variations, but in general it's good to keep things simple. So push, block, Hane, and the corner is safe. Now here white can go nobi, but white has options like Hane and use the double Hane on the outside or inside cut. And this will lead to other josekis. We kept seeing this actually. So when black captures a stone, white will atari, black can take or atari from the outside, white will connect, black can capture this stone or the bottom stone or simply extend. And then we have a different kind of fight. But these are white's options, so white can wait. Anyway, black overplayed with e4. So now white obviously cuts. Black can leave in the corner by playing the Hane at b4, then connect, and now e2 and d1 or d2, usually d2, solid, but white will capture this stone in a net. So black leaves in the corner with 5-6 points, usually like 5, and white gets at least double on the outside. So this is obviously better for white. But black tries harder, so Hane, white turns, black extends. White Hane in the corner to go for the kill. Actually, white can push again. If black plays a Hane here, it works to cut right away. So it's already troublesome. And it also works to play Hane on the second line, because on double Hane or other moves, white will atari and capture here. So you can stretch one more time. Black might nobi, then play an atari here. This gives black an empty triangle formation, and then Hane in the corner to kill, because pushing one more time on c6 will expand the white liberties. So when black goes down, you just descend, he needs to connect, and then you jump out. The bottom group is safe, the left side is safe, and black is just captured in the corner. So white goes for the capture right away. Hane, hanging connection. Actually here it's still good to connect solid, because if black turns like this, trying to capture on the left, you just Hane in the corner once. When black connects, you can Hane again, make some eye shape, and black will die faster. There are actually some cuts on the outside. You can use them right now. Well, there's actually a lot to read here, but in the end, black is in trouble. And even in the game, there was an option, actually several, to kill the corner faster. So the tiger mouth works too, in fact. But black should turn here. So when black plays this move, white can Hane in the corner once or push through and just cut. Now this is already a disaster for black, because after this cut, black needs to capture the stone. Then you just give that stone as bait, atari from the outside and capture the stones in the middle. And those are keystones. So white blocked. Black connects. White Hane in the corner. That's fine. Black connects. But now, instead of going down, you should play one atari here. This is good timing actually, Well, this can be played as a cutthroat too, but once you play it, you expand the liberties on the right side and also give black a bad shape, and there's a tesuji to avoid the ko in the corner, which is d1. Because when you just go e2, black will go down, then I think this happened in the game, but without the exchange. So the thing is, when you play d1, if your opponent goes here, and then he throws in the corner to try to set up the ko, once you capture, he cannot play c1, because he puts himself in atari. So this will create the dame tsumari and black is captured. It's a big difference between this sequence and what happened in the game. So white went down and now black can set up a ko. So you can take the ko, he plays here, then atari, he took the ko and atari again. Actually, you can play atari like this or atari like this to have some ko threats, local threats. If black plays here, you capture another stone. If black plays here, you connect and then black has to leave in the corner. But the group is alive, and he's got problems on the left. So if he wants to continue the ko fight, he needs to come out. Then you capture the ko. Now, there are not really big ko threats for black in this Fuseki. Maybe he'll try a tsuke here, which you can even resist. Then he takes back the ko, and you have more local threats. This atari, for example. He comes out, you take the ko. Or you let him play two moves. So, I mean, wait. He comes out here. Take the ko, attach, then play one atari, he comes out, eliminate the ko, he will do something in the corner, and the game goes on. So, first of all, white could avoid this ko by playing d1. Now, if you play d1 instead of e2, like this, with or without atari f4, but that will come eventually, black will try this move, then you hane, he goes down, you can play one atari. And the thing is, when you play this atari, if black connects, just atari here. So black might try c1, because when c1, if you atari e1, he can still start the ko with a1. So on this move, you gotta play a1 to make sure there is no ko in the corner. Then black has to go down. You can play one atari here, another atari here. So in the corner is seki, and then you just extend on the bottom. And black also has to extend on the left side. So this will be a 50-50 situation, more or less. Let's see what happened. So white went down, empty triangle, and black will set up the ko. Now in this kind of ko, it's not even interesting to play atari d1. If you think you don't have enough ko threats to fight and to go for the ko right now, you can just play one atari here, then extend, and let black deal with the ko, because black needs a move here. Then let's say you play away again, then he needs to capture another ko, and you can play another big point somewhere else, and he has to capture all the stones to get rid of the aji in the corner. So white plays another move. And instead of having stones, a d1 and d2, which are not important because they are neutral points, you better play three moves somewhere else. And now when black solves the ko, it's actually very slow, because black played three moves inside the corner to capture those stones, but in the meantime, you got three important big points somewhere else on the board. So the idea with playing away is to keep this ko for later. So I mean, D1, playing atari here, when you lose the ko, it's going to be just a non-profitable move, a neutral point. But if you play, so let's say this one, then extend on the bottom. Now, black will play one move here to solve the ko. But the thing is, if black doesn't have ko threats, or he doesn't want to continue the ko right now, white can always come back later to play b1 and still fight the ko. So this is the kind of ko where you have to let your opponent figure it out. So playing these two moves, you just lose the ko, but in the end, you got two neutral points. And besides, it's a pity white never played this atari first. So instead of playing here, it's good to play one atari, or you can try this combination and you have more ataris. But if you're going to lose the corner, it's better to play the atari from the side. Black connects, so this exchange is good, will help the bottom group. And then if we have this same position like in the game, already this exchange was positive for white. Because later, after the stones are captured, white will never turn at f4 in center. So now black feels, eliminates the ko, and white is left with this f3 group, which is very painful, so you need to extend J3. But if this exchange was played earlier, the Atari and forced black connect, then you can extend further away and it's a safe base. So this first fight went okay for black. But yeah, now white got to play two moves somewhere else. Anyway, here, black should no B, then take center like this, and then attack the bottom group, either here or here. But black made a mistake and went down. Should always go up to be one step ahead of your opponent, like this, or a one space jump. We have all kind of josekis here, but black shouldn't descend. So he could do this, or some light extension like this or like this, or just no B. Simply no B. If white pushes again, no B again to stay ahead. If white plays here, black can leave the position and start the attack severe on the bottom side. So black went down. White hunting the head of two stones, that's very good. Black cuts, that's an overplay. Black should play a one space jump here and then another kema to stay connected on the side. Then white has time to come back and fix the bottom. This would be proper. And actually, the game is still quite balanced. It's very early. Alright, let's see what happened in the actual game. So black cuts, white then goes down. Now, yeah, one Atari, it's okay. And then black should honey in the corner, play another Atari. But then it's time to fix the cutting point, so Q14. Anyway, white got thick in the top and it's a four sequence. So black push again, and this is troublesome because white can think about the cut at Q15. Yeah, another Sansan invasion, but actually in this position it's still very proper to play J3. Just to fix the bottom group. Okay, let's see where black blocks. This side, Hane and Nobi. He should double Hane. Once you play a Hane in the head of two stones, you gotta continue with the double Hane. So this can help the bottom stones, but still white needs an extension around here. And black hits center. So black push like this several times. And now white can enter the middle of the right side. In fact, it's good enough to play R10 or Q10 right in the middle. Because if black extends from the lower side, you go towards the top and still threaten that cutting point. So black might come back and protect. And now his wall is kind of meaningless. And if he attacks from R12, there is still Aji to enter on the right side. And then when you approach the wall, this will be kind of meaningless for black. So when you play a move like R11, it's obvious that you want to stress the Q16 group more. So here, black can descend once in center, then extend from the wall at R10. And this gives black a pretty nice moy on the right side. Then of course you will approach R14 to make a base, but here he can use Hane, Atari, and then just Kosumi to make life in the corner. So now when you cut, black will push one time, white needs to nobi, black can play Atari here, and then save the two stones in order to attack the group on the right. When you play Atari here, he can push, peep, and then leave. And now the group on the right side is heavy. So therefore, for white it's more interesting to split at R10, because you give yourself pretty much the same distance towards both black walls. But okay, that's just maybe a sensitive difference. So this happened in the actual game. Black connects, painful. White jumps out, that's good. And now the wall in the top looks a little bit in trouble. Actually here, white can also play Q9, because this is going to over-concentrate black. So when black plays the Hane, white pulls back and now there's a cutting point. And black needs to connect either like this or go up. But now he got a little bit narrow on the right side. White is stronger. White can play this cut just to see how black reacts. Also, there's an interesting move here, like this one, and then connect under. Or if black separates, then you cut and make sure you capture the stone on the right and reduce more. So, okay, I went back too much here. Jump out. Interesting wedge. Normally here, black should jump along to build a box on the right side, and when white jumps again, black has these moves in the corner to make some eye shape, then eventually jump out. It's strange to try to cut the ikentobi like this. So white answers, tiger mouth, very good. black cuts, but this is a ladder. In fact, it's better to capture by playing s12. If black comes out, just atari and push him down to the edge. Playing like this, when black goes out, he's got three liberties. You will capture the two stones, but this gives him atari here, then an approach move from the outside, so more forcing moves. But when you play atari from the second line, it doesn't do much. I mean, the only thing is to go out like this, but he will be captured much tighter. So this gives him some freedom, a bit loose, but it's still bad for black. So you capture those stones, then he's just giving more. Yeah, this game is good for the right moyo, but in fact, black is in big trouble in the top, so the urgent move is to jump out here. So he played this one. You don't need this atari to catch one stone. You can play hane and surround the whole thing. Now, if black tries to come out, he will play hane also, but the cut works, because no matter how he goes atari, one way or the other, he will be surrounded. So already the top right group is captured. When you play atari to take one stone, black can push here, he will capture one stone, and then he comes out. Or he just jumps directly. Then on this move, atari connect, push here once, or tiger mouth, if you cut, atari, and go out. So you can catch one stone, which is not even captured yet, but his tail got out. So the point is to kill everything, hane, and surround the group. Well, in the end, that group died anyway, but it was slow for white to go Q14 first. It's more interesting to play here and secure the bottom side. Actually, when you play J3, black might turn to keep the bottom group separated, but that doesn't do much. White is alive in the corner. And white can always play here in center to make black even smaller on the right side. Okay, black extends on the left, but it's a bit strange. Well, this wants to be an extension from the left side wall and just build a box there, but it's more interesting to approach the corner C14. Anyway, for black, the urgent move is to save those stones in the top. So he played here, white defends the corner. White can also defend C14 or play none, just come back and protect J3. And of course, for white, it's still big to play hane and surround the top right. So calm defense, go for the top side. Another, let's say, desperate move, this E17. It feels like a co threat. So when a co fight starts, it's good to play this kind of threat and break the top, but now just cover and black is in trouble. So here, yeah, black can play flexible, but he doesn't need to save the two stones. Just jump. And then when white captures two stones, jump again towards the right or play a hane or jump in the middle. So he connected, then defend the left side. Actually, you can think about a severe attack with this approach, then hane or a peep, and then defend the left. Because this move C14, it's a move to prevent the approach at C15, but in fact, if you play here and black plays the peep, you can just cover and try to kill the top. So defend first, black extends, but black should extend for a base at K17, it's much safer. We will see later that the group died. Yeah, finally J3, which is proper. Then a cap move, so black is going for the center now. Yeah, this hand is very good, but you should just cut, nothing happens. If atari here, connect. If atari the other way, just connect. There's nothing for black to threaten here, because he's got only two liberties. Now, if he plays atari like this, you go out. If he pushes down, you turn. If you hane in the corner, he can play all these moves, but it doesn't give him enough space to make twice. Oh, that can be a problem. In fact, not. Still okay. You kill him faster. So, should cut. Cut where you can cut. Or cut early and often. Interesting M16, but nice to cut him. Actually, here, should turn, then cut this way. Because if black cuts like this, you turn and he's in trouble in the top. He doesn't have enough liberties. Besides, you can also kill the right side with a throw-in, atari, and catch. But it's much more interesting to push and cut. And when he tries to fight back, you capture those stones too. I mean, if he plays here, you just go down. If he plays attack, you take. So there is no way out for those stones. This way, you let him... Oh, he didn't escape. He was supposed to connect here. Now it works to cut. So don't let your opponent get away with overplays. Punish them all the time. That jump is not such a big deal. If you honest, around the top should be an attach here or a Kema. And to erase the left side, it's good to play a slide. But okay, it was nice to cut at L14 and then try to kill the top. So you get into the center a little bit. Okay, left side is not too bad. This is fine. Black is captured. But now his center starts to look good. It's more to go for just one stone. Because obviously black will attack from behind and sacrifice. There are bigger moves right now. So first of all the cut here, which I guess will happen. Hane like this, Kosumi to get into the center, or try harder on the top. Let's see how can we cut those stones. Like this. So just one stone. Black will give it up. But now, black should still secure the top side. So either play a Kosumi or push here to connect the right stones and also save the top. This seems overplayish again. So capture the stone in a ladder. Very good. And that was nice to go Nobi because now you can push through. So black should play here. And when you push, it's Atari. He takes and then one space jump to enclose the center. Okay. Actually, you can punish by push, Atari, Atari, and catch this stone. Because the group is already alive, so it's nice to get into the center. Not necessary to push here. Well, the plan was that black will come back like this or like this, and now you push through and you get into the center. But you can do it right away. Just push and cut. And yeah, this move goes into the middle, and like this, black will enclose the center. But anyway, even if he does, in the end, when you capture this group on the right, it's gonna be okay for white again. So nice to get inside a little bit. Well, you don't have to push all the way, because this is a nice quadret, and it also erases one liberty, which later will cost you. So just play Hane and connect. This leaves cutting points, black will play here, and keep this push for 1 point in Sente when you fight a Ko. It's a pity to erase the Ko threats now. Well, the Atari, it's only 10 points capture, 5 stones. So when you play here, you kill 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 stones. That's 18 plus the surrounding territory, almost 30 points. So when he captures here, it's only 10. Anyway, this clamp is pretty good. So he captured 10 points and you damage more. That was fine. This one is not necessary. Here you have the clamp again. If he goes down, you cut. If he plays here, Atari. If he comes out, you catch 2 stones. And when he plays this one anyway, you take the 3. So playing here, he will just Nobi. In fact, he can play this, this, and then Nobi. But for black, it's still more interesting to save those guys. Let's see when that happens. Push and connect, it's really not necessary. Because anyway, there are no points for black here. I mean, let's say we take here, he plays these 4C moves, then he plays an Atari. So he will build 2 more points in Gote, because this Atari, you also don't have to answer. You can play other moves, he captures 1 stone, now you connect. So it's really small to play here right now. You gotta play those moves right before saying pass, more or less. So takes 2 stones, you take 1 back, that's good. Atari here is wrong. Minus, playing from the inside. This is quite big, but both black and white are missing the big picture. Now finally, white will cap. Wow, white got into the center. In fact, it's good to take right away. Because when you play Nobi, black has Atari from the outside, you need to take the stones, and now he can connect the tail. When you take right away, this move is not going to be Sente. Of course, he can still play here trying to connect, but now you have this kind of Tetsuji. He needs to defend and you separate the top. If he pushes here, you go like this, Atari, connect, now you cut left or right. So black still wants to keep the center. It works to play Atari the other way. Then when Atari here, you just capture three stones. Playing like this, black will connect. But okay, you get inside a little bit. Finally, the cut. In fact, now it works to play this move. When black comes back, you cover and you kill more. You make more profit. You kill the stones, but also more territory. Is this move really necessary? Probably. Pack, 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 pack. Yeah, otherwise it's cool. So push and cut the top. Well, top right died. You don't even need this move. It's dead as it stands. So let's say you play away like this. If black goes here, you just Atari. If black goes down, you play Atari. If he plays D18, you capture the top stones. If he connects, it's three in line, you play in the middle. So he was dead in Gote. Like this. You can just leave it. And if he plays... what else? If he plays this one, you Hane. If he plays here, you push again. There is no way to make twice. Therefore, the Hane was not necessary. Also, T19 is not necessary. If you play away and he plays T19, you false DI from the outside. If he plays here, you play T19. So this is like a double-digit Q problem. Ah, finally, Tenuki. Very good. And now the top die too. Excellent. This attack is not necessary. The group is dead as it stands, so you can play here, or you can play this wedge, Atari, and Atari from behind. Now when he connects, you can push this way. So if he blocks, you go Atari like this. Phew, that's painful. So much trouble. And then this cut, then go out, then capture this guy. Aye, aye, aye. The thing is, in the top, if black plays Atari, you connect. If he plays here, it's still dead, because you can force the eye like this. So it's only one eye in the top. Therefore, Atari is not important because there was no space for black to make another eye around M18. And this is also not necessary. So when you play from the outside and he goes double Atari, you can give him one stone and that's still a false eye. But okay, maybe this is a way to show your opponent that he is finished. So yeah, that's the way to kill. One eye only. Perfect. Fine. Well, you don't have to ladder from the first line, you can just push him Atari and Atari again from second to the first line. But it works either way. Yeah, and here it's also okay to just go down, separate. So connect, defend, Atari connect. Oh, he just lost more stones, he shouldn't. Nice, 8 points catch. Uh-huh. In fact, you shouldn't capture the stones. You can play Atari in the middle, he comes out, and then you just push. Because if he connects the stones in the tail, you take everything. So when you push, he needs to come out like this. You can push one more time, he goes out like this, and now you capture the four stones. And when he turns, you don't have to worry about the left side. But white is way ahead already, so it didn't matter much. This is wrong. Black should block M2, because now white will push. Push, block, and take the call. He connects here. We have Atari, push. No, and now the Hane. Then he pushes here, you block, and he's done. These are the last few moves. Ah, this doesn't help. Is that move really necessary? Let's say you push here, he blocks, and you connect. Now when he comes inside, you just play Atari. And when Atari, you capture them. So you don't have to play it too early. Yeah, that push is good. Nothing happens on the left side, so better keep those as co threats. And just take the co on the right, and then block here at M1. Then black takes a co, you feel one, he feels one, and you count. Q9 was not necessary. Black can push here, and then take the neutral point, because when cut, Atari, go out, connect. Or Atari, capture. These are sequences that normally one can read quite at a lower level. Also, this move is not necessary. So, yeah, strange to see the last few moves. And now black should fill the core, or white fight the core. Anyway, once white killed the top two groups, it's a large win. So, well done to come back in this game and enjoy the review with all these tactical variations. Cheers.